Common Programming. In this module, let us look at the programming part, which is common for all the switching devices. Changing home screen. Put the controller in off mode. Go to main menu. Scroll using plus minus keys to go to setup menu and press OK. Select the option utility and press OK. Scroll down to parameter 9, which is default page, and press OK. Select the option to be chosen as default, example input output, and press OK. Now press off to go back to the previous menu. Press off again to go back to default screen. Changing password. Let us now look at the enable disable protection, which is available by default, and the method to change the same. Put the controller in off mode. Go to main menu. Scroll to setup menu and press OK. Scroll down to the third option, password, and press OK. Now select the option password enable. Enable the password by selecting the option on and press OK. Now scroll to option 2 on password page. Select user password and press OK. The user password page will appear. The default password is set as 1000. You can change it to a smaller or bigger value by scrolling. Change the value to 985 and press OK. The user password is changed to 985. The advanced password can also be changed with an identical procedure as follows. Scroll to option 3 on password page. Select advanced password and press OK. The advanced password page will appear. The default password is set as 2000. You can change it to a smaller or bigger value by scrolling. Change the value to 2015 and press OK. The advanced password is changed to 2015. Configuration of type of source and priority source. The method for configuration of the type of source, that is utility or DG, is as follows. Put the controller in off mode. Go to main menu. Scroll to setup menu and press OK. Select option 5, which is changeover, and press OK. Now changeover page will appear. Select the parameter application type and press OK. Three options are available on this page, which are UG, that is utility generator, UU, that is utility utility, and GG, that is generator generator. Select an option, for example UG, and press OK. To select priority line, choose option 2, which is priority line, on changeover page and press OK. Now priority line page will be displayed showing two options, 1 and 2. Select priority line as per site requirements, for example, line 1, and press OK. Press off to return to the previous menu. Press off again to go back to default page. Time delay setting for changeover management. Following is the sequence of operations to be done for time delay setting. Scroll down to changeover in the setup menu and press OK. Select third option on this page, which is line 1 to 2 interlock. This indicates interlock time between line 1 and line 2 and is 6 seconds by default. The same can be changed and set to a value between 0.1 seconds to 30 minutes. Now scroll to select 1 second and press OK. On similar lines, the time delay between line 2 and line 1 can be set by using option 4 on changeover page, which is line 2 to 1 interlock. Scenario 1. The load is connected to source 2, DG, which gets shut down. The load will be connected to source 1, utility, after the set delay. In this case, the duration of delay should be as less as possible, since there is an urgent need to supply power as the load is not energized. Here, the default value of the delay is 10 seconds. The procedure for doing necessary setting is as follows. Scroll down to the parameter 6 of setup menu, which is line 1 control, and press OK. Scroll down to parameter 7 on this page, which is presence delay. The default value of presence delay is 10 seconds. Scroll to change the value to 1 second. Scenario 2. The load is connected to source 2, DG, but source 1, utility, has been restored. Therefore, the load should shift to the priority line, that is, utility. In this case, the duration of delay is not so important since the load is already powered up. Here, the default value of the delay is 60 seconds. The procedure for doing necessary setting is similar to scenario 1 and is as follows. Scroll down to parameter 8 on line 1 control page, which is presence delay line 2, and press OK. The default value of presence delay is 60 seconds. Change the value of presence delay to 70 seconds. Protection. System voltage and frequency configuration. To start with, let us look at the procedure for setting the system voltage. Scroll to select the second parameter, General, from Setup menu and press OK. Scroll down to parameter Nominal voltage on this page. The default value of this parameter is 400 volt and it can be set to any value between 50 volt and 567 volt. For Indian system, scroll and set the value as 415 volt and press OK. Next, let us see the steps for phase selection for voltage control. Scroll down on General page to parameter 6, which is wiring configuration, and press OK. The options available are 3-phase, 4-wire, L1, L2, L3, N. 3-phase, 3-wire, L1, L2, L3. 2-phase, neutral, L1, N, L2. And single-phase, L1, N. We have to choose the option depending on the source available at site. Select the first option, which is 3-phase, 4-line, L1, L2, L3, N, and press OK. Now scroll down to the option 7, which is voltage control. The options available are LL, LN, and LL plus LN. Select required configuration depending on site condition. For example, LL plus LN. Setting up system frequency. Scroll down to parameter 8, which is nominal frequency, on General page and press OK. The default frequency is 50 Hz. Scroll to change the value to 60 Hz and press OK. Now 60 Hz is the new default frequency. Press off to go back to previous menu. Press off again to go to the home page. Phase sequence control. Scroll down to select parameter 5, phase sequence, on General page and press OK. The default option for phase sequence is off. The other options for phase sequence are L1, L2, L3 and L3, L2, L1. Select the option L1, L2, L3 and press OK. If phase sequence control is enabled, the corresponding alarm A05 for line 1 wrong phase sequence and A06 for line 2 wrong phase sequence should also be enabled. Under voltage and over voltage protection. The procedure for programming related to under voltage and over voltage protection is as follows. Scroll to parameter 6, line 1 control on the setup menu page and press OK. Select the first parameter, minimum voltage limit, on this page. It is 85% by default and can be set up in the range of 70 to 100%. Scroll to change the minimum voltage limit, for example 75%, and press OK. Now the minimum voltage limit is changed to 75%. The minimum pickup voltage can be set by selecting the second parameter, minimum voltage pickup, on the page, line 1 control, and is 90% by default. Scroll to change the minimum voltage pickup value, for example 80%, and press OK. Now the minimum voltage pickup is changed to 80%. The minimum voltage pickup is known as hysteresis restore voltage. The values for over voltage and related maximum pickup voltage can be similarly set using parameter options 4 and 5 on line 1 control page. Similarly, these values can be set for line 2 by selecting respective options on the page line 2 control. Over and under frequency. Under frequency and over frequency parameters for line 1 and line 2 can be set with the following procedure. Select parameter 13, maximum frequency limit, on the page line 1 control and press OK. The default value of this parameter is 105%. The same can be changed in the range of 100% to 120%. Scroll to change this value, for example 110%, and press OK. Thus, we have changed the maximum frequency limit to 110%. Similarly, the set value for under frequency can be changed using the parameters on page line 2 control. The default value for this parameter is 95%. The same can be changed in the range of 80% to 100%. On similar lines, the set values for over and under frequency for line 2 can be changed by selecting respective parameters on the page line 2 control. Alarms. The controller display gives different types of visual alarms to indicate various problems. A total of 22 alarms have been provided, out of which 18 are pre-programmed. The last 4 are user alarms and can be programmed as per the requirement. If an alarm is generated, its number gets highlighted in status panel. If this alarm is set as global, the option global at the bottom on the right hand side of the screen also gets highlighted. Now let us see the procedure for enabling and disabling of various alarms. Scroll down to parameter 16, which is alarm table, on setup menu page and press OK. This will take you to the alarm table page. You can now enable or disable different alarms as per the requirement. After you have made necessary changes, press OFF to come back to the previous menu. The user alarms can be programmed as per the requirement by selecting parameter 15, which is user alarm, on setup menu page. Generator related programs. Now, let us look at programming related to generators. Output. Controller to generator. The output types are start and stop. In this scenario, it is assumed that utility is the priority source and generator is the secondary source. Output 3, with terminals 23 and 24, is programmed for generator start and stop signals. When the output is active, the signal is high since it is set to normal. When the output is inactive and is in a normal mode, the activation creates low to high signal. An option is also available in which output is high by default and activation leads to de-energizing of that output which is low to high signal. The procedure for setup is as follows. Scroll down to option 11, Digital Output on Setup menu page and press OK. Select parameter 3, which is output 3 on this page and press OK. Select the option Output Function, which is the first option on this page and press OK. Now scroll down to select the option Control Generator 2 and press OK. Come back to Output 3 page and scroll down to Parameter 2, which is Output Type. There are two options available on Output page, Normal and Reverse. Select the option as per site requirement, for example, Normal, and come back to the previous menu. Input, Generator to Controller. Feedback from Generator is to be connected to Terminal 19 of Input 5 of the controller, and the same is to be programmed as follows. Select Parameter 10, Digital Inputs on the Setup menu page and press OK. Now scroll to Option 5, which is INP5 on this page and press OK. Select the first option, Input Functions on this page and press OK. Scroll to select the option Generator 2 Ready on this page and press OK. Press off to come back to previous menu. The option Generator 2 Ready is selected. Time delay. Let us look at the procedure for setting the generator cooling time delay. It is the time delay between load disconnecting from generator and generator engine actually stopping. The procedure is as follows. Scroll down to Line 2 Control on the Setup menu page and press OK. Go to Parameter 20, which is Cooling Time on this page, and press OK. The default cooling time is 120 seconds and can be set between 1 second and 1 hour. Scroll to select the appropriate value and press OK. Press off to return to previous menu. Factory default settings. Finally, let us see the procedure when the user wants to restore factory default settings. Go to main menu. Select the option Command Menu and press OK. Scroll down to the parameter C11, which is set up to default, and press OK twice. Now, all the factory default settings have been restored.